So we're headed to the nearest tavern, I presume?
A couple of them, if you'd like. I'll be at the main doors when you're ready to go.
You're doing Baldur's Gate a great service. We'll not forget it.
Soon I must join an expedition to Dragonspear Castle to face Kalar's crusade. The Grand Dukes of Baldur's Gate are concerned about the Paladin Kalar Argent and their growing army. Waterdeep and Daggerford feel the same, and soldiers from all three cities have been dispatched to confront the Shining Lady at Dragonspear Castle. I shall join an expedition leaving soon to aid in the war effort. Perhaps at Dragonspear I can learn why the Shining Lady sent assassins after me and put an end to her and her crusade. I've secured the palace, but the crusade remains a threat. After a bloody battle, the palace is secure. The assassins appear to have been sent by Kalar Argent, the leader of a crusade currently wreaking havoc across the Sword Coast, north of the Winding Water. Well. Oh, Skie, says Sapphire, over here. Where? Hello?
Such menial tasks.
You remember me. Surely you do.
What are you waiting for? Come and talk to me. I don't think we ever met her. I'm afraid not. Have we met?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought... I don't know what I thought. Well, I'm Skie. It's nice to meet you.
Oh, Skie, not Skie. There was somebody... She is the daughter, I think, of an Entar Silvershield? Or the other Silvershield whose name starts with E. And we had met somebody who wanted to help us free her from her father. He wanted to elope or something with her. I might have met her in the... Very briefly, it's Entar Silvershield Estate. Yeah, I might have met her there. So it is Entar. The other one, I think, is the one who fell ill. I get them mixed up because they both start with E like that. So Skie. And you too.
I heard you talking to Daddy and the other dukes about Kalar. Are you going to Dragonspear?
Shining Lady and I have business to settle.
Daddy hasn't told you everything. Did he mention he thinks Kalar might be one of Baal's children? Yeah, I thought not. We can't talk here. I'll tell you more later.
All I can do is wait for Skie to approach me in private. The music keeps swelling here. I have once again crossed paths with Grand Duke Entar Silvershield's daughter, Skie. She hinted that she has something to tell me, but only if we can meet alone. Skie has changed little, still bright and adventurous, not that I'd know. She lacks maturity and has a remarkable callousness to others' suffering. Perhaps with age, she'll gain some perspective. All right. I'm gonna look around a little bit.
Order is what matters.
The council has let Kalar go too far. The crusade must to be stopped before it reaches our gates.
We're more than mercenaries.
It's time for the Flaming Fist to snuff out the Shining Lady's light. Past time, if you ask me. Let's, Liia. These windows look out into the green courtyard of the palace. In the center lies a garden. Who's that? Fill with brightly colored dahlias imported from Aglarond. Liia?
Hello. I am glad to see you well.
And are you? Tell me, how fares Imuin?
The intruder's weapons were poisoned, but Timora smiled upon us. The poison was weak and fatal only to the weakest of victims. Imuin's heart beats much stronger than that.
Good to hear. Of course, you could have just said, she's okay.
It's worrisome that the palace was so easily penetrated, and to learn that Kalar's reach extends this far beyond the winding water.
What do we know of her plans?
Precious little. She claims herself an instrument of the gods, which gods are a matter of some debate, on a divine mission. As to what that mission is, it is as countless as the mouths that praise her and those that curse her. I am glad we had a chance to speak before you depart. But now, I must go. There are many demands on my time. If I do not attend to them, their number will only grow. Farewell.
Fare thee well. She's still there, though.
Hello! I am glad to see you well.
As well as an assassin's target can be, Grand Duke Jannath.
The intruder's weapons were poisoned, but Timora smiled. It's worrisome that the palace was so easily penetrated, and to learn that Kalar's reach extends this far beyond the winding water.
Here comes the music again. I've thought more of Kalar than I care to of late. How goes Imuin's magical training?
She is an attentive student, but magic requires a clarity of thought and feeling she struggles to maintain. Still, that's not unusual for one her age.
Indeed.
In time, I am certain she will be able to access and control the Weave's power. But she must be patient and take the time to know all facets of the craft. Failure to do so could be disastrous.
First we heard of the Weave. This is how you access magic. Define disastrous.
I will advise her to remain in Baldur's Gate while you journey to Dragonspear, if that's what you're asking. Whether she takes my advice is another matter.
It's not exactly what I was asking, though.
She'll accompany you if she wishes. You know her well enough to know she'll not be swayed once she's made a decision. But she's not nearly ready to use magic. While her other skills may prove useful to you, she's at a critical time in her training. Her past instincts pull her one way, her study of the craft another. Until that conflict is resolved, you will find her less than effective as a magic user, or a practitioner of her other skills.
So she's of no use as a thief or a magician?
She cares for you. The last thing she wants is to be a burden, but until she fully recovers and her training is complete, I fear she would be. I am glad we had a chance to speak before you depart. But now, I must go. There are many demands on my time. If I do not attend to them, their number will only grow. Farewell.
Fare thee well. I'll take this stuff. Potion of Infravision and Strength. Do I have room to put this in there? Yeah. That's full. History of Waterdeep 2. I've read that. Now, is this... are these the same rooms I've been in? Oh, here's Entar Silvershield.
We're more than mercenaries.
Entar?
Yes, what does the hero of Baldur's Gate need of me?
100,000 gold and a teleportation spell to take me far away from Kalar's crusade. How are you, sir? How is Skie?
Better now that she is no longer under the sway of that noxious pig dog Eldoth.
Eldoth.
But only a little better.
That's what I was thinking of.
The girl is determined to vex me. She throws herself into the jaws of the world, not realizing the dangers awaiting there. I fear it will take extreme action on my part to prevent tragedy befalling her.
Yeah, I remember talking to Eldoth, but he already had a full party, and the only way we could take on his quest was to have him join our party, so I turn him down.
So it seems to me, at least. I am sure she would tell a different tale were you to ask her.
Did she sell us not to say something? Well, that would be causing trouble to call his daughter that. I may do that. For now, I mean, it's okay if he says it. I'll ask what you know of the situation up north.
I have scattered reports, rumors, conjecture. It is said the crusade holds sway from the high moor to the winding water.
I do not remember him having that accent in the game. The base game, Baldur's Gate.
The High Moor and Misty Forest are Kalar's, as are the Serpent Hills and most of Trollbark Forest. She has much of the Troll Hills too, but even she avoids Warlock's Crypt, so far at least.
Warlock's Crypt? Sounds interesting.
After her attack on you, I think her bold but reckless, willing to attempt anything to further her agenda, whatever it is. But for now, you must excuse me. The council must see to the city as you see to Kalar. Timora favor your travels.
Thank you. But I think I can actually talk to you more. Jospel?
Yes. What does the hero of Baldur's Gate need of me?
I understand you suspect Kalar Arjun is a child of Baal.
After Saravok, we'd be fools not to consider the possibility. But there is rumor and conjecture. If you two share blood, that's all the more reason for you to represent us, no?
Perhaps. How fair is the city during all this turmoil?
Thanks to that damnable Argent woman, we drown in a sea of refugees. The Flaming Feast is having trouble enough keeping order as it is, and will have more when the Dragonspear expedition leaves. I don't know if Kalar seeks to cripple Baldur's Gate, but if that is the goal, she may well achieve it.
Have we any idea what her goal might be?
Ideas, certainly. Facts, not so much. I have scattered reports, rumors, conjecture. The High Moor and Misty Forest. After her attack on you. But for now, you must excuse me. The council. Yes, what does the hero of Baldur's. Thanks to that damnable arrow. I don't know if Kalar seeks to cripple Baldur's Gate. But if that is the goal, she may well achieve it.
This is what I wanted to ask. Will the Fist be able to keep the peace with its forces spread out?
Eltan would know better than I. Given the attack on the palace, Kalar is moving more quickly than we anticipated. As for what happens next, your guess is as good as mine. Perhaps better? No, not really. My guess would be slightly better than yours.
Oh, no. You were right the first time.
But for now, you must excuse me. The council must... Yes, what does the hero of Baldur's Gate need of me?
Anything different here. 100,000 gold and a teleportation spell to take me far away from Kalar's crusade. Failing that, you can tell me what you know of the crusade and its mistress. It'll probably be the same answers.
I have scattered the High Moor after her attack. But for now, you must excuse me. The council must see to the city as you see to Kalar. Timora.
You are welcome here.
It's a bad business. And terrible business. All of it. A terrible business? What is? I'm too depressed to talk right now. Give me a moment, please. I need to compose myself. Huh? I should try to cheer Jospel up. What is it called? The War at Home? A man named Jospel asked me to give him a moment before speaking to him. He seems very depressed. Perhaps I can do something to improve his morale. I have no idea what that might be.
Good day to you.
Good day to you. Terrible business. Terrible, he says. It can't go on. It just can't. Is it a good day, though? Reports are coming in by the hour now. The world's a disaster. Homes put to the torch. Refugees filling Baldur's Gate with God knows how many more on the way. Where do these reports come from? From the north. Kalar's crusade has already taken Dragonspear Castle. Bridgefort will fall soon. Doesn't already. Bridgefort? Aye. It's a settlement next to Boreskir Bridge. During the time of trouble, Sirik and Baal battled each other there. The water west of Bridgefort has been fouled, poisonous to drink ever since. You mentioned Dragonspear Castle? The adventurer Daros Dragonspear built a castle on the edge of the High Moor, midway betwixt Baldur's Gate and Waterdeep. He died ages ago. It's been a ruin for years, with only monsters and bandits going near it, until the Crusade took it as their base. I have another question. Talking. That's all we do, isn't it? Can't stop the Crusade's march. Can't keep them from taking Boreskir Bridge. Helpless. That's what we are. The Dukes call upon the best and strongest the land has to offer. We will thwart the Crusade. Perhaps you're right. Maybe we can change things. Is there anything else I can tell you? What more can I tell you? Did we solve the quest? Who is responsible for the chaos running rampant in the north? Kalar Argent and her mad crusade, of course. What do they call her? All right, the Shining Lady. What do you think Kalar hopes to achieve with this crusade? No one seems to know the ultimate goal, but whatever it is must require a lot of people. Kalar's got an army marching across the Sword Coast, and it's growing. She claims her followers enjoy divine protection from all who challenge them. Lunacy, I call it. Tell me more of this Kalar. She's an Argent, a family known for its service to Lathander, the Morning Lord. Lathander is, a god, right? There are priests of Lathander. Most of her ancestors were paladins in the Order of the Aster. Some say there's divine blood in her veins. She's convinced her followers they can face any challenge and emerge triumphant. I have another question. All I hear every day is more talk of the Crusade. Someone's got to put these dogs down. Either Waterdeep or Baldur's Gate. It makes me sick what they've done. Perhaps Kalar knows something we don't. Who's to say the Crusade won't do some good in the world? The Lords of Waterdeep and Baldur's Gate, that's who. They'll not let Kalar's rampage go unchecked. Why are there so many refugees? The Crusaders are doing a lot of damage to settlements up north. What sort of damages? As they march south, the Crusaders demand food, weapons, and other supplies from settlements they encounter. What isn't volunteered, the Crusade takes by force. What settlements are the Crusaders targeting? Farms, villages, even small towns. Those who resist are driven out. But the Crusade recruits as many as they displace. More even. Veterans who cleared out Dragonspear Castle 10 years past, when devils poured out of it across the land, are eager to find a new cause. And those whose fortunes were lost to the Iron Crisis are desperate for any hope. The Crusade grows every day. I have brothers in the north who are missing, thanks to the Crusade. I can't stop thinking about it, wondering what's happening or happened to them. Dwelling on it keeps you from taking action here. Honor them by not giving in to despair. That actually makes me feel better. Perhaps I will see my brothers again. I must be going. Farewell. Well, I do feel a bit better now. That's something to be thankful for. Take my staff with you. Maybe it'll help you out. I learned something of the Crusade from Jaspel. Jaspel told me about the Crusade and the Shining Lady, Kalar Argent. I was able to cheer him up a bit. He gave me a quarterstaff as a token of his appreciation. I got a quarterstaff, oh, Brevin's quarterstaff, plus one. The soldier Brevin brought this quarterstaff from home when he first left to make his fortune. Once he earned enough money to purchase a better weapon, the quarterstaff wound up in a weapon supply in Candlekeep. At some point it was retrieved and enchanted, switching owners several times along the way. Nice. We can just equip this to get lore plus 10. And we can cast Friends once per day. Thaco is plus 1. And it's damage 1d6 plus 1. That's pretty cool. Alright. I need someone to help me carry this stuff. Alright, I'm done talking to Entar. Did I talk to... is a noble one.
Simply no standards these days.
Excuse me, I'm late for an important meeting. Well, excuse me then.
War is almost here.
An ill tide is coming. You can mark me on that. Marked you shall be. There's Corwin. I'm not going to talk to her until I'm ready to go.
We're more than mercenaries.
On the bright side, the crusade in Baldur's Gate may mean the refugees move elsewhere.
We're more than mercenaries.
If Eltan ever gets a hold of Kalar, she'll rue the day her servants cross the Winding Water. Ooh, someone just appeared. Nobleman.
Such riffraff everywhere.
Do I look like I have the time for idle conversation? Be gone. Duke Eltan. And that's Duke Entar. Those are the two I got mixed up. And on top of it, Eldoth is the one who Skie's betrothed or boyfriend or something. You got way too many E names here. I will talk to Entar and these guys too.
We're more than mercenaries.
Someone will pay dearly for what's happened here.
We're more than mercenaries.
The council has let Kalar go too far. The crusade must be stopped before it reaches our gates. Indeed.
Greetings. How are you holding up?
Well enough, sir. And you?
After Sarabak's defeat, I had hoped for peace, but it was not to be. I grow too old for this sort of thing. Once it would have excited me, now... I am simply weary.
I understand.
A Kalashite monk once told me, every night is dawn's herald. The trick is to hold on to the memory of light until the darkness breaks.
They call Kalar the Shining Lady. She fancies herself the light that will break the darkness. I have been called many things in my time, Sapphire, but my mother was no dog. Names are just words, and words can be twisted. However Kalar or her followers try to justify their actions, they are disrupting commerce throughout the Sword Coast, and our people will suffer for it. My mother was no dog. Why would he say that? Did I offend him? Not for long. Kalar tried to kill me. She will answer for it.
Your words are welcome. And they give us hope in these difficult times. Oh, if you do venture into the city, be sure to take Captain Corwin with you. A talented officer, that one. She'll take care of you.
Thank you. Alright, so I've helped myself to the stuff in here. Maybe we can go up and check on Imowyn. If she's up here. Who's this? Is that noblewoman? Yeah, okay.
Fine.
I don't know if anyone's hanging around up here. As a servant?
You are welcome here.
Is there something you need? I'm here to serve, my lady.
Fine.
Someone just fell down again. Oh, so she's been moved off the carpet. That's good. I wonder where they put her.
We're more than mercenaries.
Assassins in the High Hall. How could this have happened?
We're more than mercenaries.
Yeah, where's Grand Duke Belt? Fenster? Oh, here she is! Alright, that's the same text as before. Fenster.
I welcome you with outstretched hand.
Your friend needs rest now. I doubt you could awake her, even if you tried. But it would be best for all if you didn't try. Leave us now. Please? And why is she in my bed if that was her room? I mean, not that I mind.
A simple matter.
Just why, man? Why? Oh, here's Belt. Alright, I wanted to talk to him.
Accept my apologies. My intent was to keep you and Imowen safe. Kalar's assassins, indeed any assassins, should never have been able to breach the palace.
Can't help but agree there. What happened to your voice? What happened to Endar's voice? These things happen. Speaking of happening, what in the hell's happened to your voice? Ah, yes, you wouldn't know. An old friend from my adventuring days caught up to me shortly before the Iron Crisis began. The Flaming Fist dealt with her, but not before she managed to place a curse upon me. Irritating, but not life-threatening. Even so, I'm glad to have my true voice restored. That might offend him. I can't imagine. What can you tell me of this Kalar Argent? I wish there were more to tell. Our scouts in the Troll Claws and Highmoor have had little success tracking her movements. In the process, many of our people have gone missing, or worse, left our service to join her. What could turn loyal servants against their own city? Adherents of many faiths flock to her banner. What she hopes to accomplish is vague, but that's done nothing to diminish her followers' devotion. This is all we know of the woman who threatens us and all the Sword Coast? She first appeared on the High Moor with a handful of followers. Their ranks swelled alarmingly fast. Initially, their efforts were geared towards taking control of Dragonspear. Once the castle was seized, more flocked to her cause. Her army spread out in all directions, and now it has reached us. I hope you can end this threat. We shall see about marshaling our own troops and preparing for another attack.
Accept my apologies. My intent was to keep you and Imowen safe. Kalar's assassins, indeed any assassins, should never have been able to breach the palace.
What matters now is their intent. Baldur's Gate's rulers were within these walls, yet they targeted me. The same thought had occurred to me. Perhaps they believed they could slay all within the palace, and you were just one of many Kalar sought to eliminate. No, I don't think that's it. By all accounts, the Shining Lady's will is iron, as are her followers. She trusts too much in mercenaries, though. Enough coin may turn that to our advantage. I'm not sure people who rely on the Flaming Fist should look too closely at turning mercenaries against their paymasters. I understand the concern, but until we know more about the nature of the threat, all options must remain on the table. That's the nice thing about options. It costs little to consider them. It's actions that cause all the trouble. You beard it with a quick wit, Sapphire, but you have more to offer the city than magic and the occasional quip. So, you know, it's pretty much all magic and quips, yeah. Continue down the path you're on, and you could someday be one of the Council of Four. You flatter me, sir. If I really had a strategic mind, I'd be halfway to Kalimshan right now, not heading north to Dragonspear. The Shining Sea is lovely this time of year. If events continue in the direction they have been, I might just head south with you. But for now, my place is here, and Dragonspear is yours. Timora bless your travels, and swift journey to you.
Such riffraff everywhere.
Getting people to notice your good deeds can be challenging.
You are welcome here.
I dreamed about peeling potatoes last night, all night. I need a change of pace. Maybe peel some carrots instead. Okay. There's important conversations, and then there's, well, potatoes. So I think I looked in here, right? Yeah. Alright, so we go through here to go down, which is interesting. I think. Well, I'm coming out there, I guess? No, I'm on the stairs.
Fine.
Well. And we leave through here. Okay. So, next episode, I'm going to talk to Corwin, and I'm assuming we're then leaving and finding our companions, which would be great. We'll bring them back here and get all their stuff again. So, we're going to an inn or two, apparently. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.